I'm here at Comic-Con in New York City, and I'm with one of my favorite artists, Matteo Scalera. I actually found Matteo on Black Science, which is an amazing, amazing book. And I'm just here to ask these artists, these amazing artists, some questions to hopefully help you guys learn. So, how you doing, Matteo?
Good, how are you, man?
Good, good.
Are you enjoying the show so far?
I am, and I have to tell you, it's an honor to meet you finally. I've been watching your stuff for years and reading all of it for many years, so
thanks. I really appreciate it.
So I have a couple of quick questions. Number one is, you know, how did you start? Like, what was your art education? Did you go to college? Are you self-taught?
So, well, first of all, I live in Italy, so I'm not from the States. So, yeah, my education was basically I studied in art school in that period of my life.
So you had art classes in high school?
Yeah, it's basically from, in Italy, it's from 14, 15 to 18, basically. And then I started studying graphic design. So that's my starting point.
It's interesting. How does that affect you now, right? Because there's a couple of guys out there I find if they took graphic design, like suddenly their composition and stuff is way better, right?
Yeah, absolutely. That's the main thing, like composition, learning how to balance the image and with colors as well. That's why even though I'm not a real painter, I can still manage to understand the theory behind colors because that's what they teach you, especially back then. It was a main thing to create the balance between colors and shapes and stuff like that. So it was really important. I wish I could have done, you know, they called it back then decoration as well, which was painting and all that stuff. But, you know, I'm learning as I'm working that kind of stuff.
I love that they called that final stuff decoration.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It was a pictorial decoration. That was a technical term for it.
Yeah. So hear that, everybody, right? Like, the drawing stuff is first, right? The decoration is later, right?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, definitely.
That kind of leads us into that, you know, we were talking earlier about the importance of drawing, you know, like, what does that mean to you? You know, has drawing affect you? You know, how do you use it? How did you learn it? I guess, you know, like you said, I guess it was in college, like.
Yeah, absolutely. I learned it in college, but one thing that helped me really get better at it, if it makes sense, and sorry if it's not answering directly the first question you asked, but it taught me how to memorize stuff that I see. It taught me how to observe things in a different way. So even now, as we're talking, I look at the folders on your clothes and I try to put them somewhere in my storage room.
Right.
And maybe next time when I have somebody, you know, I have to draw somebody holding a microphone, maybe I remember, oh, that day, you know, with Mike and New York Comic Con, I remember that fold that was really, you know, nice, probably I'll try to do that. So mainly it taught me that, like how to memorize stuff and put it somewhere in your brain and maybe, you know, dig it up later.
I remember when I was younger, I went to art school here in New York and the teachers would always say, create your own like clip art folders. You know, I would have a filing cabinet in my room basically, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Now you have that digital stuff too, but to your point, you try to hold that in your memory and start understanding all the stuff.
Yeah. And you got to train your brain how to do it. Right. Like I remember one thing that helped me a lot. I was already doing it without knowing. Like there was some anime, something cartoons that I would watch and I would learn all the outfits or the characters.
Right.
And then after, without watching it, I would try and reproduce them. And that's a really, really good exercise. But even, you know, gathering stuff from, you know, whatever, newspapers, just cutting. Now you don't need it with the internet and everything, but back then it was the 80s. Early 90s, so we didn't have internet, so you had to do that, you know, actually like collect physical pieces of paper and stuff like that.
A lot of your work has, you know, has force in it. What I teach, you know, a lot of movement and energy. Did that come from school, or was that something you felt like you already had?
Oh no, it was really instinctual. I gotta be honest with you. I realized it's one of those things that you realize after. Because people start asking you questions and at first you don't know to answer them.
Right.
And somebody noticed that and tells you like, oh, because you're really good, you know, with lines and that's what gives you the energy. I was like, oh, yeah, right. Now I understand my own thing. Right. But so it came out pretty naturally. Probably ability of observe things a certain way. So I was already absorbing stuff from authors that I liked. And probably instinctually put it on the page. And now I understand like why I do it and, you know, and how I do it. So, and again, especially if you're seeing your book, I already know that you understand me and you understand what I'm talking about.
Yeah, we're the same language.
Yeah, it's all about the lines and everything. You don't even need sometimes to explain too much. As long as there's lines, the right lines that convey in the right points.
That's right.
And it's the rule for everything. If we're, you know, folds and clothes, which you have an abundance of in your book,
right.
It's all the same thing. It's all about energy and point of traction and point, it's all thing.
Right.
So, and that's the secret for, if you want to be a dynamic artist, you know, depending on what you want to be, but that's my main thing. It's the energy, as you said. So,
well, I want to thank you for your time.
I know.
It was really a pleasure meeting you.
It was my pleasure. And yeah, absolutely. I love this book. I got to tell you, absolutely. So, if you haven't yet, just, go buy the Force Fabric.
Yeah. And I want to promote what you're selling here today, your own work, right? You got, 50 Shades of Grey.
Yeah.
Right?
This is my new art book that came out a few months ago, and it collects, all the latest sketches that he did, during this last couple of years or so.
Did someone buy this?
I hope so.
You can buy it here if you're here in New York Comic Con, but probably when you see this video, it's gonna be too late.
Yeah.
So you can buy it on www.essentialsequential.com. Essential Sequential is a big agency that represents a bunch of artists and, you know, manages us when we have to go to shows and stuff like that. So, and it helps us with, you know, sketchbooks and whatever we want to do, prints and stuff like that. And we also recently got a license from Marvel to do official Marvel prints and stuff like that.
Oh, that's awesome. All right. Well, thank you again. It's a pleasure.
Cheers, guys.